First Corinthians chapter 13 describes love. And that chapter is often called the love chapter. And verses 1 through 8 reads like this: if I could speak all the languages of earth and of angels, but didn't love others, I would only be a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. If I had the gift of prophecy, and if I understood all God's secret plans and possessed all knowledge, if I had such faith that I could move mountains, but didn't love others, I would be nothing. If I gave everything I have to the poor, and even sacrificed my body, I could boast about it, but if I didn't love others, I would have gained nothing. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous, nor boastful, nor proud, or rude. It does not demand its own way. It is not irritable, and keeps no record of being wrong. It does not rejoice about injustices, but rejoices whenever the truth wins out. Love never gives up, never loses faith, and is always hopeful, and endures through every circumstance. These three things will last forever: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of these is love. And then over in Ecclesiastes, we find these words: two people are better off than one, for they can help each other succeed. If one person fails, the other can reach out and help. If someone falls alone, he's in real trouble. Otherwise, two people lying close together can keep each other warm. But how can one be warm alone? A person standing alone can be attacked and defeated, but the two can stand back to back and conquer. Three are even better, for a triple braided cord is not easily broken. And the scripture that is referring to marriage, the three braids, is the husband, the wife, and God. If you'll keep God in your life and God in your marriage will be very, very successful. Now, Jerry, I'm going to challenge you. You know there's no saying when we're single, guys. It's all about the chase. And then we get married, and there's no more chase. And that's wrong. This is a special lady. She's special to you, or you wouldn't be going through this right now. You decided you want to spend your entire life with her. So I challenge you, don't ever get comfortable in that fact. Don't ever lose the fact in your mind that this is a special lady to you and to your family, that you love her with all your heart. I challenge you both to always take time out for each other. Life goes on. Life is difficult. Jobs, problems, bills, money, things happen. And sometimes we forget. We've got each other to lean on. You always remember that. You've got each other. That is your strongest asset with each other. Lean on each other. Care for each other. Imagine this. I don't know if you know what a Stradivarius violin is. They're worth millions and millions of dollars. The original Stradivarius. If I was to hand you one right now, it would look like an ordinary violin or fiddle. And you probably think, what's going on here, Pastor? And if I told you that was worth millions and millions of dollars, you might even tremble a little bit as you held it, but you'd be in awe of it. You'd think, my goodness, this piece is worth millions and millions of dollars. This is your Stradivarius violin. Always be in awe of her. You always need to be in awe of Jared. Y'all are going to be helpmates throughout life. It's going to be tough. It's going to be difficult. There's going to be times when she's going to be so down, and I'm going to use the word depressed. I don't mean that in the literal sense, but just down because of life's problems and vice versa. And that's when you need to lean on each other the most. Pick each other up. Remember why you are doing what you're doing today. Remember this day. Remember this special occasion. Remember the dates that you had together, the times you had together up to this moment. Always have time for yourself. And since it's your desire to enter into the holy matrimony, I'm going to ask now if you'll join right hands and repeat your vows after me. Jared.
I, Jared.
Take you, Katrina.
Take you, Katrina.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance. According to God's holy ordinance. According to God's.
According to God.
Holy ordinance.
Holy ordinance.
And therefore.
And therefore.
I pledge you my faith.
I pledge you my faith.
Katrina. I, Katrina.
I, Jared.
Take you, Jared.
Take you, Jared.
Be my wedded husband.
Be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
Richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And therefore I pledge you my faith.
And therefore I pledge you my faith.
Jared, do you have a token of your love and affection for Katrina and me? If you'll place it on a ring finger and repeat after me. This ring I give to you.
This ring I give to you.
A circle without end. Token and a pledge of our constant faith and ever abiding love. With this ring, I be with. With all my earthly goods, I be endowed. Be endowed. Trina, you got a ring for Jerry. It's good. Laughter's good. If you get this paper, then you'll hear this stuff. Okay? You know, that's a neat thing. You remember that? This ring I give you.
This ring I give you.
A circle without end. You ain't got me doing it. As a token of the pledge.
As a token of the pledge.
Of our constant faith.
Of our constant faith.
And everybody love.
With this ring,
I be wed.
I be wed.
With all my earthly goods.
With all my earthly goods.
I be endowed.
I be endowed.
At this time, Katrina is going to place a necklace on Jared's daughter. This is her way of saying that she's not just marrying Jared, but they are a family. Jared and Katrina have sent it together to the holy wedlock. They've been witnessed today for you and God. They've given their pledge of faith to each other by the power vested in me. I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss your bride.